Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines, and by request, thank the Lord, I have requests, different ones for prayer of salvation, and the Lord is, I just prayed about it, and the Lord led me to a text, Isaiah 53. This was written about 750 years before the birth of Christ by the prophet Isaiah. We have copy, there's a copper scroll copy there in Jerusalem. They have the Dead Sea Scrolls, and it's called the, it's shaped like the big scroll, the copper scroll. That's the one they found, at least from 200 or 300 B.C., a copy of Isaiah made on copper sheet. So, you know, that's proof of the entire Bible, I think, except for the book of Esther, I think it is. It's not in there. And the Dead Sea Scrolls and the book of Enoch is in there, too. And so let me read from this written about 750 years before the birth of Christ. Who has believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of dry ground. He has no form or comeliness. He's not handsome. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. For he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement or the withholding of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid upon him the iniquity of us all. It goes on, brothers and sisters, but the verse that the Lord wanted me to give to you was that we all like sheep have gone astray. And our dear Lord Jesus Christ said, when he spoke with his disciples in the book of Matthew, he said, what shepherd having 100 sheep, when he lost one of those sheep, would not leave the 99 and go get the one? And when he got that sheep, he would rejoice with his fellow herdsmen that he had found that one sheep. How much more are we worth than a sheep? The Lord also said, a lost person is like a coin that a woman had many coins and she lost one. She would turn the whole house upside down looking for that gold coin. And when she found it, she would rejoice and even call her neighbors to rejoice with her for the coin that she had found. How much more are we worth than a coin? See, the Bible says that all of us have gone astray. Each one of us has gone our own way. And the Master calleth for us. Jesus said, no man can come to me unless my Father draws him. And Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice. They know my voice, and they answer not to another voice. See, the Lord can speak through me. He can speak through anybody, any of his people. The Lord can speak his very words. So right now, as I'm speaking by the voice of the Good Shepherd, speaking through me, by his Spirit, by his word, that he's calling you as a people unto himself. The Lord has set us apart, the Bible says, as a peculiar people, a holy nation, to be kings and priests unto our Lord and our God. The Lord has called us who were not a nation to become a nation. That's the church. We were not a nation. God used us to provoke the nation of Israel to jealousy. So when we get raptured out of here, which can be any day, the Israelites will be provoked to jealousy. And then the Lord will begin to work with them and deal with them to receive Jesus as their Messiah. But right now, the door of that ark is still open. And the Lord is standing like in that song, softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. He stands on the porch, the portico, the portal, the entrance of the ark of heaven, and the Lord is calling. He's calling out to us. Like that song, come home today. Those who are weary, come home. The Lord said, come unto me, all ye who are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I want to tell you something, all who are watching this video. The burden of the Lord is light. The yoke of the Lord is light. There's no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk according to the Spirit and not according to the flesh. Jesus said, those who believe on me shall not be condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already. Then it goes on in the same chapter, John the Baptist says that the wrath of God abides on those who are not followers of Jesus. It remains on them. See, all of us were born in sin, and the wrath of God remains on us until we become born-again Christians. The Bible says we're lost and without hope in this world. John chapter 1 says that in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Then in that same chapter down it says the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And it says, "Is to as many as those who receive him, Jesus, the Word of God, as many as who call upon his name, to them who call upon his name, who believe on Jesus Christ, to them he gave power to become sons of God and daughters of God." The Bible says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. That's one of the greatest verses in the Bible. The wages of sin is death, from Adam all the way till now. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Jesus himself said, for God so loved the world that God gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believed in him, the only begotten of the Father, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, Jesus the Christ, shall not perish but have everlasting life. Jesus became sin for us. He took upon himself our infirmities and our diseases. I just read from you from Isaiah. It's quoted again in 2 Peter. He himself bore our sicknesses and our diseases. He took our sin. He took our punishment for us. Like the movie The Passion of the Christ. When I went to go see that movie The Passion of the Christ, when it came out, I couldn't believe it. I mean, even though, of course, I was already a pastor, I already knew the Word of God, and I even asked the Lord when I was leaving the movie theater. I said, Lord, you're God, did you really feel the stripes? I mean, did you really feel it? What? And the Lord said to me clearly, yes. Yes, I really felt it, of course. Yes, it was real. Yes, I felt it. And the grief that came upon me after seeing that movie, The Passion of Christ, you know, the grief I had for the Lord, every time the Lord was hit, as they say, the Roman punishment is 40 stripes save one, you know, 39 lashes. They give you one less out of grace, out of mercy. They give you 39 when the standard punishment is 40 lashes. Jesus took 39 stripes with those cat of nine tails and all that for me and you. And every time he's hit, it's by his stripes. We are healed. He took our sickness, our disease, our sin upon himself. Unbelievable. Jesus said, you know, greater love hath no man than he would lay down his life for his friends. Jesus laid down his life for all who will come unto him. As Peter said in Acts chapter 2, this, you know, talking about the baptism of the Holy Spirit, this is for you, your children, your children's children, and all those who are fall off, as many as the Lord our God would call. If you're watching this video, and especially those who messaged me asking me about salvation, the Lord is calling you, and I praise the Lord that you're here today meeting with me to say yes. And all I am is just a facilitator, just an instrument of God. And his hand, his voice, his word manifested out of my mouth, his spirit and his word, to pray with you right now to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So I ask anybody who's watching this, becoming a Christian is not complicated. That's what we call religion. Religion is like a bad word to me. It's a system of rules and regulations that man makes. You know, like as example, Catholicism, all these pomp and circumstance, you know, and then I guess they're probably kind of an extreme example of pomp and circumstance and costumes and outfits and all that. It's like some kind of a play, you know, it's just a masquerade. God's all about this one right here, our heart. What's in our heart? Jesus said, no one who comes to me will I cast out. Anyone who comes to calls upon the name of the Lord will receive you. All you have to do, Jesus said, for God so loved the world that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. The Bible says, if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. It says, the Bible says, all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Now, let me add this to it. When we read all through the book of Acts and all that, when Paul preached, when Peter preached, when all the preachers in the Bible preached in the New Testament, they said repent, and Jesus said that, and John the Baptist said repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. I made video about that. Go watch that. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So you need to repent of your sins. You know, God's grace is given to forgive us. You know, he forgives us of our sins. It says, if we confess our sins, he is just and faithful to forgive us and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. See, we have to confess our sins. We have to call upon the name of the Lord. Why? We want to go to heaven, and in order to enter heaven, you have to be forgiven of your sins. So how can you forgive, be forgiven without asking for forgiveness? That's what we're talking about, repentance. Turn from your way. Say, Lord, you know, I've been on drugs. Lord, I'm a homosexual. You know, Lord, you know, I killed somebody or whatever. You know, I've committed adultery. All the above. You need to give that to the Lord and say, Lord, you know, I'm a sinner. I'm a liar. I'm a thief. I've broken all the Ten Commandments or what? You know, I'm a blasphemer. I've taken your name in vain. That's one of the Ten Commandments. I've, you know, bore false witness. I've lied. The Bible says all liars have their place in a lake of fire. All fornicators, almost everybody is an adult. You committed fornication. You've committed, lots of people have committed adultery. All those things. That's violating the Ten Commandments. So we've broken God's rules, and we deserve punishment. That's why those of you who have messaged me, you've already realized by the hearing of the Word and reading the Word and studying the Word and hearing my and other people's messages, you've been convicted that, hey, I'm lost. I need to be saved. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to pray with you. You do not have to follow the prayer that I say exactly. You can say what's from your heart. Jesus was crucified for you, he and me. He died on the cross in our place. The wages of sin is death. It says Jesus took upon himself our sicknesses. He took our diseases. He took our sin. He became a curse for us. He took the sin of ours. He died in our place. He died in our place on the cross. We deserve to be on the cross, but Jesus got in our place. So you need to confess that. Jesus, you died for me. You took my sin, my diseases, my punishment, my wrath of God is on you. The word is propitiation. In other words, he's standing between us and the wrath of God. It's like that Ark of the Covenant. You know, he's like the mercy seat. You know, and they sprinkle blood on the mercy seat. And then under the mercy seat, you know, you've got the law and all those things of man. You know, the manna, provision of God. I made a video about that thing too. The things inside the ark is our provision. The jar of manna, the Aaron's rod that budded, and the Ten Commandments. That's the human stuff, see? It's under grace. That mercy seat is under the mercy seat and sprinkled with the blood of bulls and goats and Jesus' blood. Jesus sprinkled his blood on the real ark, which is in heaven, not in the one on earth. The Bible says, Book of Hebrews. So we're under the blood. When you get saved, that mercy seat, you're under that mercy seat. And then Jesus is the mercy seat. He's the one that's standing in between us and the wrath of God and the judgment of God upon all sin. Our sin is removed by the blood of Jesus. Jesus is our advocate. He's our mediator. There's one mediator between God and man. That's the man Jesus Christ, the Bible says. You don't need any priest, no pastor, no pope, no president of a country. Nobody's going to stand between your parents. Nobody. It's just you and the Lord Jesus Christ. And he's our judge. He judges the quick and the dead, as the King James says, the living and the dead. He'll judge all. And that's a whole other video about the judgment of the church for our rewards and the judgment of the lost for their place in hell. Brothers and sisters, right now I ask you to come in agreement with me and pray over everyone that would pray to receive the Lord. All those Christians who are watching this, pray in agreement. Pray for those people who are come to the Lord through this video and pray that God will use it more and more. And I ask each watcher to make a video like this. Let's pray. I want you to pray with me right now that your faith be in the Word of God and the Spirit of God, that all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. I'm going to pray with me right now. Lord Jesus Christ, just repeat after me. Lord Jesus Christ, just I know you died on the cross for me. Lord Jesus, forgive me of my sins. Lord Jesus, I know you rose again on the third day. And Lord, in just the same way, you will raise me up, Lord, to eternal life. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Just like the parable that you told of the tax collector that went into the temple, he didn't even look up, but he looked down at the ground and hit himself in his chest and said, Lord, forgive me because I'm a sinner. Lord, you said that man went out of the temple justified in your sight. Lord, you said you give grace to the humble, but you resist the proud. Lord, we come to you in humility, Lord, that we are lost without hope in this world, Lord God, and we need you, Lord God, to deliver us from death, hell, and the grave, and from eternal destruction and damnation, Lord. Lord, we receive your grace and mercy through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, through the blood of Jesus Christ, Lord. We receive your forgiveness. We receive eternal life and salvation through you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Save me, Jesus. Save me, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving me. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me. Thank you, Jesus, for delivering me from Satan's hands and into your own hands. Lord, as your word says, you've translated us from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of your dear Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. We thank you, Father, for giving us the good gift of Jesus Christ and salvation in him, the person of Christ. We have salvation. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, please message me. Please give a testimony, and I'll share it on here if you want me to. And you can go back and watch my video about being baptized in the Holy Spirit if you want to jump all the way in and go deeper into the Lord. But when you're saved, you're saved. You know, that's as far as you need to go as far as receiving more from the Lord. You know, it's the deepest you want to go into the Lord, a new babe in Christ. And I would just tell you, I'm trying to cut this off so I can get it loaded up. You know, learn to read your Bible. Keep watching my videos and other, like Pastor Dave's videos and other people. Revelation 3:11, lots of people have good videos. If anybody has a video that's another gospel about keeping the law and all that, Paul said there's only one gospel. That's salvation by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. No works required, but your repentance and calling on the name of the Lord, you'll be saved.